All the way back in 2014, we started working here with the Scottish Government, with the NHS Highland, to figure out how could you deliver capsule endoscopy, or how do you can you deliver GI diagnostics in a better way, and capsule endoscopy was the way forward.
The capsule itself is probably about the size of a large antibiotic, and the patient swallows that capsule down.
It takes up to 35 pictures per second.
Really what it does, it creates another option or a choice for patients rather than having to go down the traditional colonoscopy route.
Scotland does not have the capacity it needs to investigate all the people that need an investigation.
The waiting time to have normal diagnostics, endoscopy services, the waiting time has expanded because we haven't been able to staff endoscopy units. There are a number of people who are waiting for diagnostic services with symptoms. And in that group, there will be patients who have bowel cancer.
A number of things worked really well in the project. The main thing for me was we got the service design right. And that wasn't by accident. A huge amount of time and effort went into that, using professional design researchers, supporting the clinical teams in developing a service model.
And I think we're really learning a huge amount about how to implement the service, how to make it really beneficial for staff and patients, and really how we can deliver this on a much wider and more sustainable scale.
All of that is based on evaluation, making sure we're getting it right for the patients, taking feedback from the patients to understand if it works for them. And as we move forward, making sure we refine how we deliver services that suit the needs of patients.
The one major piece that we instigated quite early on in the project was an innovation partnership procurement process. This was the first of its kind in the UK.
And that brought together not just government, academia, the NHS boards delivering the service, or the clinicians, the managers, patient groups, but also industry colleagues sat round the table with a common sense of purpose.
There's a lot of projects in the future that will benefit from the learnings that we've had throughout this process.
Already we've taken forward pieces of work as a result of ScotCap in a way that we probably wouldn't have done previously.
What none of us anticipated was the emergence of the COVID-19 pandemic, which coincided with the end of the trial.
The pandemic's obviously has changed the direction of travel, or certainly seen us scale up much more quickly than we would have envisaged. We need to do that in a safe way to make sure that we get it right, and that the patients are having a positive experience as part of that, and that we continue to listen to feedback and refine it as we go.
If you can go to your local general practice, your local pharmacy, and be supervised having your colon capsule endoscopy, not having to take time off work or find childcare, and not having to drive into town and find a parking space in a busy hospital. If we can make it so accessible, I really believe that we can change the incidence of bowel cancer in Scotland.